Hello everyone, I am Mr. Sachin Rathod, working as assistant professor in mechanical engineering department from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are dealing with a reverted gear train. So in this session, the learning outcome is at the end of this session, student will be able to calculate the speed ratio of, the simple diagram is there for the reverted gear train. So in this diagram, so reverted gear train is nothing but if the input axis and the output axis of the shaft on which the gears are mounted are coaxial, then it is called as a reverted gear train. So in this gear, gear number one is a driver. Consider gear number one is a driver and gear number four is a driven. The driven gear. So we are getting the motion from one gear is connected to the second gear, and on the second gear and the third gears are mounted on the same shaft. So it is a kind of the compound gear train. So second gear and third gear are mounted on the same gear, same shaft. So from the gear number two to shaft and gear number three are rotated with the same speed. So from the three it is transmitted to the gear number four, which is the driven gear. So we can transmit the motion from first gear to the second, second to the third, and third to the fourth. And here this, the shaft for the driver, it is called as the input shaft, is having the coaxial with the output shaft. So it is called as a reverted gear train. So this kind of the reverted gear train, we have to find out the speed ratio. Already we are knowing what is meant by speed ratio. The speed ratio is nothing but speed ratio is nothing but it is the ratio of speed of driver divided by speed of driven. So this is a, we can call driver gear divided by speed of driven gear. Okay, so it is called as a speed ratio. So the speed of the driver gear divided by speed of the driven gear, it is nothing but the speed of the driver is nothing but the 1 and driven is nothing but the 4. It is equal to the n1 by n4. So it is also kind of the compound reverted gear train. So we can find out the speed ratio in terms of the number of the teeth is nothing but number of the teeth we can calculate. It is equal to product of number of teeth on driven gear divided by product of number of teeth on driver gear. So if you observe this mechanism, this is the driver gear, this driver gear for this driven gear, and this is a driven gear. So this is a driver gear for this driven gear. So 1 and 3 are the driver gear for 2 and 4 driven gear. So we can call product of number of teeth on the driven gear. So 2 and 4 are the driven gear. So we can call T2 into T4 divided by product of number of teeth on the driver gear. So 1 and 3, T1 into T3. So it is nothing but N1 by N4. So we can, this is a formula for finding the speed ratio. And second thing is that if you observe this mechanism, the distance between the two shafts, these two shafts is, suppose we can call the distance between the two shaft is x. So we are getting, so this is the radius. Suppose the gear number one is having the PCD is this much, so the radius we are getting is much. So this we can call for the gear number 1, this is R1, gear number 2, it is R2, that is the pitch circle radius. Gear number 3, it is R3, and gear number 4, it is R4. So x is the distance between the two shaft is equal to R1 plus R2, okay, is equal to R3 plus R4. So just we require these two formula. By using these two formula, we can easily find out the speed ratio or any geometry from this reverted gear train. So you can think about the, what are the applications of reverted gear train. So this is a question for you. So the generally, if you observe the lathe machine at the back gear box of the lathe machine, we are using the reverted gear train. Okay, so the application, main application in case of the back gear of lathe machine. Okay, so consider this numerical. So we have to solve this numerical. So in this question, the speed ratio of the reverted gear train as shown in the figure is 12. So speed ratio is nothing but we are knowing speed of the driver divided by speed of the driven. So here the NA and ND, this is the driver by driven. So we are getting NA by ND is equal to 12. The module of the pitch of the gear A and B is 3.125. Therefore, MA is equal to MB is equal to 3.125, and C and D, that is MC is equal to MD is equal to 2.5. So calculate the suitable number of the teeth on the gear. Okay, so we have to calculate the number of the teeth, that is TA, TB, TC, TD, that we have to calculate. So in this question, so the speed ratio they are given us, so we can simplify this. So the speed ratio is nothing but NA by ND, and in case of the reverted gear train, we are knowing that the speed ratio, that is a speed of the driver by speed of the driven, is calculated by the product of number of the teeth on the driven gear divided by product of number of teeth on the driver gear. So we are getting TB into TD divided by TA into TC. So by using this formula, we can calculate the speed ratio. So here they are given as a speed ratio is equal to 12. So we can simplify this. We are getting TB by TA is equal to square root of 12, and TD by TC is equal to square root of 12. Because in these two gears, the transmitted power should be the same. That's why we are getting TB by TA is equal to. So if you make the product of this, we are getting the speed ratio is equal to 12. So we can easily calculate TB is equal to square root of 12 TA, and TD is equal to square root of 12 TC. So we are getting the relation between A and B. So this is a first equation and the second equation. Next expression, we are knowing the distance between a two shaft, that is a X, they had given us 200 mm. Therefore X is equal to RA plus RB is equal to RC plus RD. Therefore we are getting X is equal to 200 is equal to RA. We are knowing the relation between R and M. Here the R is equal to MT by 2. So therefore we are getting MA TA by 2 plus MB TB by 2 is equal to MC TC by 2 plus MD TD by 2. So we are getting MA TA plus MB TB is equal to 400, and MC TC plus MD TD is equal to 400. Just we have taken a common 1/2, it will get 400 into 2, we are getting the 400. So we are getting the two equation. So here the MA, MB are the same, 3.125. therefore we are getting TA plus TB is equal to 400 divided by 3.125, and TC plus TD is equal to 400 divided by, here the MC and MD are the same, 2.5, it is coming to the 2.5. therefore TA plus TB, okay, TA plus TB is equal to 400 by this, TC plus TD is equal to 400 by this. So we have to solve this. This is equation number 3, equation number 4. So by comparing the equation number 1, 2, 3 and 4, we have to calculate the value of TA, TB, TC, TD. So for making the calculation, we are getting here TA plus TB is equal to for the calculation purpose 400 divided by 3.125, we are getting 128, and TC plus TD is equal to 400 by 2.5, we are getting 160. So this is equation number 5, equation number 6. So here we are getting TB is equal to square root of 12, 3.464 TA, and TD is equal to 3.464 TC. Therefore, by putting the value TB is equal to 3.464, we are getting TA plus 3.464 TA is equal to 128. Therefore, TA is equal to 128 divided by 4.3. So we are getting 28.67. Similarly, TC and TD, if you put TD is equal to 3.428, therefore we are getting TC plus 3.464 TD is equal to 160 TC. Therefore, TC is equal to 160 divided by 4.464 is equal to 35.84. Therefore, if you consider is equal to 28, TA is equal to, and TC is equal to 36. Therefore, if you put this value in this equation number 5, we are getting TB is equal to 128 minus 28 is equal to 100, and TD is equal to 160 minus 36. 160 minus 36, we are getting 124. So these are our answers. So we are getting TA is equal to 28, TB is equal to 100, TC is equal to 36, and TD is equal to 124. So like this, we have to solve the equations. So here are the calculation for this TD and TB calculation. So these are my references. Thank you.